So after we've gotten some data in here, we now can start to unlock some of the cooler new features of PowerTeacher Pro, and that is best shown in the Progress tab. So when I click on Progress, and I'm going to go to Traditional, I've actually switched servers so that you can see more data. This is still a fake school and fake account, so none of this is personal or private information that we're sharing in the video. But what I get here is an instant snapshot of where my students are in the class. 18 have an A, 5 have a B, 1 has a C, 1 has a D, 4 are failing. Now, if I need to get a little bit more information, I can click on the View All. Now, what I'm looking at here is quarter four results. Notice how, as I'm looking at the breakdown for quarter four, I also start to see some trends. So if I look at Emily's score here, Emily is knocking it out. In quarter three, she had an F, she's got an A minus, and so that little arrow in the green is showing a positive trend from her stored grade in quarter three to her A in quarter four. In the reverse here, I do have students who are slipping. These might be folks I need to really talk to. This student here, Jordan, started with an A in quarter three, but now is failing. That'll be a student that I probably need to either contact counselors or get some more stakeholders involved to find out what's going on with that large of a slip. This is all instantly happening. PowerSchool is doing this analysis for you so that you can get a quick dashboard of what's going on in your class. Now, if I click OK, one of the other areas that I can click on over here on the right under Progress is this heads-up display of all of my students' absences, their number of tardies, so anything related to attendance, side by side with all of their assignment tags. So these are things that I put in the gradebook. I marked the number of things that were late, I marked the number of things that were missing, incomplete, etc. And as we get closer to that quarter four grade, I'll see all of this side by side. So another really great way to use the Progress tab and jump over to and use the data that's being stored in PowerTeacher Pro to have student conferences, have parent conferences. This is a sheet that you want to print and have ready to go once we get around to those times of the year. Now, that's pretty much it for the Progress tab as of this moment. Again, this is one of the newer features of PowerTeacher Pro, and they're going to be developing other views or looks into your student data so that you can get a quicker dashboard view. We're going to move on to, in the next video, the reports. The way I like to think of the difference between these two, Progress is going to be what's going on in the middle of the quarter. So let's say, for example, I want to get that snapshot for conferences before the semester closes. Progress is anything that I want to analyze or look at before I close out a grading period. And when we move on to reports, that's going to be the reports and printouts that we generate to finalize grading periods, send home progress reports, etc.